Okay, so this is our fourth lecture actually of English literature, and I'm your teacher, Miss Sibra. As you all know that we have already done lesson number one, and now we are at lesson number two, and you know that we have three chapters in each lesson. So we have done first chapter of this second lesson. Okay, now we are going to start lesson number two and the next chapter. Okay, I have already told you that the important characters about of all these second lecture, that Mr. Murdstone, who is the stepfather of David, then Clara, who is the mother of David, then Mr. Creakle, who was the owner of Salem House, which is the boarding school where David was sent by Mr. and Miss Murdstone. Mr. Mell was the teacher. James Steerforth and Tommy Traddles, they both are the beginning stage friends, you may say, or they are the very first friends of David Copperfield. Now, we have done this chapter, which was Salem House. Okay, David reaches to Salem House unwillingly by Mr. Murdstone, because he was not willing to go there. Okay, he was not willing to leave his mother, he was not willing to leave his home and his previous school, but Mr. Murdstone forced him and compelled him to go over there and proved him as a wicked boy in front of his mother and in front of everybody. Okay, and then at the Salem House, Mr. Mell picked him and took him to the school, where in the class he got unnoticed, and nobody was over there, but he got the notice lying on the floor. There is a cardboard sheet on which it was written that what was the notice? The notice was, "Be careful, he bites." Okay, so as a punishment of finding that notice, Mr. Mell put that notice on the back of David Copperfield. So it was the punishment of David Copperfield because he had found that notice and put himself on the desk, on the top of the desk. That's why Mr. Mell told that you have found this notice and you have to, so you have to wear this notice on your back. Page number is 10, and we are now going to start the next chapter. The next chapter's name is The Notice. We are going to start today. Okay. Now, the important characters of this notice will be Mr. Creakle will be there. Okay. Because in this chapter, you will get to know that the holidays are over now, and Mr. Creakle, his family, and all the boys will be coming from their homes after spending holiday. So he found the notice over there, as well as he found so many friends. Now I'm going to start the reading. Whatever is the question will be coming in your mind, just note it down in your register or notebook, wherever you are having all the previous lectures. Note it down over there and we will discuss it at the end of the class. So now I'm start reading the notice. He lifted me off the desk and tied the notice on my shoulders. Everywhere I went, I had to wear it. He means Mr. Mell. Mr. Mell lifted him down. Lifted me off means usne usko desk se utara. It is the phrase you may say. He lifted me off the desk and tied the notice on my shoulder. And he tied with a rope or ribbon to his shoulder the notice. Everywhere, wherever David is going, he had to wear this notice on his back. No one knew how much I suffered, whether people could see me or not. I always imagined that somebody was reading that piece of cardboard. Means wherever he was going, wherever he was traveling, David was thinking that everybody is watching me at the bedside and they all are reading the piece of that cardboard sheet on which the notice was written. Okay, because he was confused. He has something on his back, so he was very confused, and he has a thinking in his mind. He imagined that somebody or anybody was reading that piece of cardboard. Soon, there would be 45 boys in the school, and I imagined all of them crying out in their different voices, "Be careful, he bites." Means he was saying that when the school started and all the boys came, total 45 boys were over there in the school, and he was imagining, he was thinking that everybody is in his own voice, in his particular voice, everybody was shouting that "Be careful, he bites," which was the notice. Okay, crying means, here crying doesn't mean that he was crying, he was weeping, ke wo ro raha tha. No, here crying means that everybody in his own particular voice, they were mumbling, they were wo apne muh mein kuch na kuch baatein kar rahe the. Okay, and the sound was so confusing, so that's why he was saying that the sound is like crying. Okay, after about a month, Mr. Creakle returned. After 1 month of happening all these things, Mr. Creakle returned from the holidays, from the picnic. I was ordered to go to his room before I went to bed that evening. In the same evening, I was ordered to see him, to meet him before going to bed. Sone jaane se pehle, you have to meet with the owner, you have to meet with Mr. Creakle. When I saw him, I was very frightened, okay, because of his appearance. You may say he was very much frightened by looking at him, at his personality. Mr. Creakle was a fair gentleman with a bunch of keys and a watch on a chain. Means he was a fair gentleman with a bunch of keys and a watch on a chain. He was sitting in a large chair with a glass and bottle beside him. All the time he has got the bottle and a glass with him. He had a red face which made him look very angry. Means he was also an angry person, you may say. His face is like we have already done a cross-looking woman, which was said for Miss Murdstone. So his face was also like an angry man, and small eyes deep in his head, a little nose and a large chin. So all these appearance things, when you are hearing, when you are listening, so you have made an imaginary face in your mind. ठीक है ना, जब भी हम किसी चीज के बारे में सुनते हैं तो हमारे माइंड में, हमारे ख्यालों में एक पर्टिकुलर फेस बन जाता है. माई फेस विल बी डिफरेंट फ्रॉम योर्स. ओके, सो व्हाट टाइप ऑफ पर्सनैलिटी ही वॉज? ही वॉज अ फैट जेंटलमैन एंड ही हैड अ रेड फेस विद डीप आईज इन हिज हेड. बहुत ही छोटी छोटी और अंदर को हुई हुई आईज थी. ही हैड अ वेरी एंग्री फेस, यू मे से स्मॉल आईज, लिटिल नोज एंड अ लार्ज चिन. ही हैड सम थिन हेयर दैट लुक्ड वेट, मीन्स जो उसके उनके छोटे छोटे पतले पतले बारीक से बाल थे. Brushed over the sides of his head, means it was on the only borders, only on the sides of the. अच्छा रोमैसा मुजफ्फर, I'll repeat it. Okay. Umar Amjad, is my voice now? It's okay. I will Rumesa, I will tell you. Just wait a minute. Okay, so it was on the top, but none on the top. Means beech se wo ganja tha. He was bald from the center. Okay, and at the side of the head he was getting very thin hairs. Okay, acha, hairs is not a word, hair is the plural of hair. Okay, hair, no s with hair is a plural, ye koi word nahi hai, please be careful about that. However, there was one thing about Mr. Creakle that frightened me more than his appearance. He had no voice. After all, beside all these things, beside all this appearance, beside all this look, the one thing which is more frightened for David, it was his low voice. His voice is so very, very much low that nobody can hear if he is not concentrating on his voice. Agar koi usko gaur se sunne ki koshish na kare, nobody can hear him. Okay, unki voice, he had no voice, means he had very slow voice. He only spoke in a whisper, means jaise hum kaano mein कुछ चुपके चुपके बोलते हैं, दिस इज कॉल्ड द विस्परिंग. ओके, तो हिज वॉइस इज जस्ट लाइक ही इज विस्परिंग विद द पर्सन हु इज टू हूम ही इज टॉकिंग. वो जिससे भी बात करते थे उनकी वॉइस इतनी स्लो थी दैट ही इज विस्परिंग. मिस्टर क्रिकल वांटेड टू टेल मी दैट ही वॉज अ डिटरमाइंड मैन लाइक माई फादर. डिटरमाइंड मीन्स हु इज वेरी स्ट्रिक्ट एंड वेरी मच फर्म इन देयर डिसीजन. जो अपना एक इरादा कर लें तो उसको करके रहते हैं. दे डोंट डिस्ट्रैक्ट हियर एंड देयर. डिटरमाइंड मीन्स द पर्सन व्हाटएवर ही हैज थॉट टू डू ही विल डू दिस. क्योंकि वो अपने ट्रैक से फिर कंफ्यूज नहीं होते, दे डू नॉट गेट डबल माइंडेड, क्योंकि वो जो कहते हैं और जो सोचते हैं वो करके रहते हैं. तो दिस इज कॉल्ड द डिटरमाइंड मैन. मिस्टर क्रीकल वॉन्टेड टू टेल मी दैट ही वॉज अ डिटरमाइंड मैन लाइक माई फादर मिस्टर मडस्टोन एंड दैट ही वुड मेक मी ओबे हिम. And what does he want? That you have to obey whatever I am saying to you because I am not lenient person. Whatever I am saying to you, you have to obey that order. When I tell someone to do a thing, I make them do it. He whispered at me, pinching my ear fiercely. Means उसने उसका कान को खींचा and he said that whatever I am telling to someone to do, the person has to do this. I will not distract my mind from here and there by anyone. कि वो किसी की भी बातों में नहीं आते थे. एंड ही यूज्ड टू मेक द पीपल दैट यू हैव टू डू दिस. ओके, आई वाज वेरी फ्राइटेंड बट आई हैड समथिंग वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू आस्क हिम. प्लीज सर, आई सेड माय वॉइस ट्रेम्बलिंग मीन्स उसकी आवाज कपकपा रही थी बिकॉज ही वॉज वेरी मच फ्राइटेंड बाय दिस पर्सन. वो बहुत ज्यादा डरा हुआ था बट ही हैड टू आस्क समथिंग वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू हिम. प्लीज सर, आई सेड माय वॉइस ट्रेम्बलिंग, प्लीज मे आई टेक दिस नोटिस ऑफ माय बैग. उसने क्या पूछा कि कैन आई टेक दिस नोटिस ऑफ माय बैग, क्या मैं इसको अपने बैग से उतार सकता हूँ. बिफोर द बॉयज कम बैक, कि जब तक बॉयज आना जाए. Means there were only 45 students in the school. Okay, there were more. और भी ज़्यादा थे, but only 45 were present over there. More has to come. और उन्हें अभी आना था. तो I am very sorry indeed, sir, that I behaved so badly. But can I take this off? क्या मैं इसको उतार सकता हूँ? I am very sorry on my behavior. Mr. Preaker leaped up from his chair and I ran. I did not stop running until I reached my bedroom. Means जैसे ही Mr. Preaker he stood up from his chair, he ran away from her because usko laga ki wo mujhe marenge, whatever he was thinking about him, but he ran and he didn't stop running. Wo us waqt tak bhagta raha until he reached to his bedroom. I lay on my bed trembling with fear for about 2 hours. Wo 2 ghante tak bed par leta raha and he was just trembling. Wo kapkapa raha tha ya kaanp raha tha yun se. Theek hai. Luckily for me, the first boy to return thought my notice was very funny. His name was Tommy Traddles. See, he was the first friend of David who told him that your notice is very funny. He introduced me to all the other boys saying, look at this, here is a good man. Here is a good game, sorry. Okay, usne kya kaha ki look at this, look at the notice and it's a good game. We can play that. Some boys pretended that I was a dog and stroked me and said, lay down, boy. At first, I did not like this, but then I saw they were playing a game and being friendly, I decided that the notice was not as bad for me as I had expected. Means, the notice on his back was very much, you may say, he was thinking that it's very funny for me. All the people are making fun of me. But after some time, when they started playing game with him, then he understood that the notice is not so much very bad as he was expecting. Usko lag raha tha ki ye bahut bura hai, mere sath acha nahi karenge, people will make my jokes, wo mujhe joke ke taur pe lenge. But when the boys, when his friends or when his schoolmates started playing with him regarding that notice, he thought that the notice was not as bad as I was thinking. Okay, it's okay to be friendly with them, unke sath friendship karne ke liye, to be mingled in all the students, mix up hone ke liye mujhe, I have to play this game and I am feeling very good at that time. Now turn the page number 12, it will be. The oldest boy in the school was J. Steerforth. J. Steerforth is a short form of James Steerforth. He was 6 years older than me, means he was continuously learning in this Salem house. Okay, maybe he failed ho raha ho, yeah, he was repeating, he had got a gap in his studies, that's why. And he was 6 years older than David. He was very kind to me. He helped me use my 7 shillings to buy fruits. Means that shillings which was given by Miss Peggotty as a token of love, you may say, and his mother's behalf also. Okay, he has got 7 shillings. James Steerforth helped him to spend this 7 shillings to buy fruits, wines, cakes for the boys. Means he had to give the treat to the other boys. So he used that all shillings to buying fruits, cakes and wine. We had a feast in our bedroom in the middle of the night. Feast means ek achhi khasi daawat kar di thi usne. The boys were pleased with the food and at the feast they told me many things about the school. Means while having this all feast, while having this you may say a party, this refreshment jab wo chal raha tha, to they all the boys were very pleased with that and they told him many things about the school. School ke bare mein jo bhi particulars the, he didn't know about that. That's why he started asking. So everything was told to him by that. As now the next third last chapter of the second lesson. Okay, before that somebody asked me to tell about the first lesson, which was Salem House. Okay, I'm just repeating it for maybe Rumesa was there who was asking. Rumesa, in the Salem House, it is the first chapter of Away From Home. In that David reaches Salem House. Okay, he was compelled to go to leave the house to go to the Salem House by his stepfather, who is Mr. Murdstone, and his sister Miss Murdstone. They compelled him to go over there. They proved him that he is a wicked boy. He had to go in the boarding school so that he will spend all the time over there and learn his lessons very carefully, because he was you may say he is not learning the lessons, he will not be a good boy in future. So they sent him to the Salem House. Then at that place in the Salem House, Mr. Mel met him and he took to the Salem House the actually school building, and he also took him to his class. Okay, where he got the cardboard notice over there on which it was written that be careful he bites. When he got that notice, he thought that there is a dog in this class. That's why he took on the top of the desk. वो वहाँ ऊपर चढ़के खड़ा हो जाता है. And for this he had to get this punishment by Mr. Mel that you have to wear this notice on your back. Okay, I don't want you to wear this. Mr. Mel told him that I don't want you because you are a new boy. There is no mistake of yours, but I am ordered to do this and I am compelled to do this. So you have to wear this on your back. This was the brief introduction about Salem House, which was the first chapter. Okay, now we have done the notice. Okay, he asked to Mr. Treacle that can I take this off, but when Mr. Treacle started to tell and he stood up from the chair, he ran away. Then he met some friends over there in the in his room, and now we are going to start the third chapter. Mr. Mel loses control. Okay, lessons began next day. The roar of voices in the classroom suddenly stopped when Mr. Treacle entered. Okay, next day when the school started, all the boys came over here with Vanda, which was the first day of the school. When Mr. Treacle entered into the classroom, the roar of the voice means jo ek shor sharaba jo class mein, obviously when you are not having the teacher in your class, everybody is talking, shouting. You people also, when you were in the school in the class, you people were also making shout. Okay, so the class mein teacher nahi aata. Okay, so we are having so much fun in the class. We are talking, exchanging the things, stationery, whatever, and somebody is talking about the course, books, syllabus, classwork, and somebody was talking about their household things. Yesterday we went over there and this and that. So it was a roar of voice. All the voices are mixed up. Sari cheeze mix up ho rahi thi. Nobody can understand what the students are saying, but it was like a roar of voice. So it suddenly stopped when Mr. Treacle entered. Now boys, he whispered, this is a new term because his voice is so slow. So we are saying here that he whispered. Usne kya whisper kiya ki now boys, this is a new term, be careful to behave yourself. Okay, you have to behave very very good, very well in this term. I advise you to work hard at your lessons. This is actually the entering speech of Mr. Treacle. For I shall work hard at the punishment if you don't. Means agar aap hard work nahi karenge on your behavior, if you will not concentrate on your behavior, on your studies, on your lessons, so I will have to work hard for the punishment of yours. Ki agar aap is par work hard nahi karenge to mujhe aapki punishment decide karne ke liye work hard karna padega. So it's better that you will work hard about your lessons and your behaviors, and I will not be punishing you. I won't hesitate. You won't be able to rub out the marks I shall give you. Means whatever the marks, whatever the remarks I am giving you, you cannot rub that. You cannot erase that. आप उसको erase नहीं कर सकते. So you have to be very careful about your studies and your marks also. Now start working, all of you. Means now your classes are going to start, and now you people start working. When this dreadful speech was over, Mr. Creakle came to my desk. He said that he knew I was famous for biting. Okay, means he had got the notice. When this dreadful speech was over, Mr. Creakle came to my desk. He said that he knew I was famous for biting. Means I was famous. David is famous for his notice on his bed. He was famous for biting too. उन्होंने क्या कहा कि if you are famous for biting, I am also famous for biting, he said. He showed me the stick. उन्होंने उसको stick दिखाई. Wasn't that as sharp as a tooth? क्या ये उतनी ही sharp नहीं है जितनी कि हमारे दांत sharp होते हैं? I can also bite with the stick, you may say. Couldn't it bite like a tooth? After each question, he struck me with it. जैसे ही वो कोई question पूछते, he struck उसको वो stick मारते. Then again the second question and struck him. And very soon I was in tears. और फिर वो इतनी जोर से उसको stick लगती that he was started crying. Steerforth did his best to protect me and was a most useful friend. Means Steerforth had did his best. उसने हर कोशिश कर ली that he could protect David and he was a very useful friend. But he could not. लेकिन वो उसको Mr. Creakle की stick से he could not save me. Or anyway he did not defend me from Mr. Creakle, who was very cruel to me. There was one advantage in Mr. Creakle's cruelty. उसकी एक cruelty से उसको क्या advantage हासिल हुआ? However, he liked to strike me every time he walked past me, but he found my notice got in the way. Means he was saying that advantage of Mr. Creakle's cruelty is he liked to strike me every time he walked past me. जैसे ही वो उसके पास से गुजरते, he became used to of striking him. वो उसको मारने के आदी हो गए थे. But he found my notice got in the way. और फिर वो उसको notice उसको he had to get it off. For this reason it was soon taken off and I did not see it again. Then the notice was gone and David could not see that notice again in the school life. I was helped a good deal by Mr. Mel, who liked me, but I was unhappy to see that Steerforth treated him very badly. Means I was helped a good deal means Mr. Mel tried a lot to help David. Mr. Mel also liked David because he is innocent. He hadn't done any wrong thing. But I was unhappy to see that David was unhappy to see that James Steerforth was not treating with Mr. Mel behavely. वो उनके साथ misbehave करता. Then page number 13. One Saturday, poor Mr. Mel was teaching and the noise in the room was terrible. There were laughing boys, singing boys, talking boys, dancing boys, shouting boys, running boys and joking boys everywhere. Means the boys were laughing, singing, dancing, they were joking, they were making fun with each other, they were running and shouting in the class. So Mr. Mel was, it was a very mess in the class and he was getting disturbed with that. Silence, cried Mr. Mel, suddenly standing up. Why are you making so much noise? I have no more patience left. Means अब मेरे अंदर बर्दाश्त या सबर नहीं है. Why you people are making so much noise? I am very annoyed with you. I am getting very much angry with you. Do you realize how unfair you are being to me now? Whatever you are doing, it is very unfair with the teacher. Okay. The boys all stopped. Some of them suddenly surprised. Some half afraid, and perhaps some were sorry. Means कुछ ने तो sorry कर लिया. Some stopped doing all the things whatever they were doing, and some were half afraid. Means कुछ डरे हुए थे, but they were still doing something wrong. Okay. Steerforth was standing at the far end of the long room. He was leaning against the wall with his hands in his pocket. Means वो हम एक पाँव पीछे wall पे stick करके और एक पाँव नीचे. ठीक है, he was leaning means एक पाँव पर वो खड़ा हुआ था and second leg was on the wall and both hands were in the pocket and looking at Mr. Mel thought he was whistling. Okay, वो उसको उनको क्या लगा कि that he was whistling. Silence, Mr. Steerforth, said Mr. Mel. उन्होंने उसको क्या कहा? Silence. Silence yourself and said Mr. Steerforth and don't give orders to me. Then the student Steerforth ने Mr. Mel से क्या कहा कि silence yourself. तुम चुप हो जाओ and don't give orders to me. No need to give me orders. Sit down, said Mr. Mel. उन्होंने क्या कहा with the Steerforth that you should sit down. Sit down yourself. Then whatever Mr. Mel is saying to Steerforth, he was asking to do the same to Mr. Mel. जो Mr. Mel उसको कहते हैं वो Steerforth उनको वापस पलटा के दे देता. Some of the boys laughed and few clapped, but Mr. Mel was so pale. Pale means I told you, the pale means the face color is getting very yellow. Okay, रंग उड़ जाना या चेहरा सफेद पड़ जाना या face pale पीला पड़ जाना, this is called pale. Mr. Mel was so pale that they were immediately silent again. The boys started laughing and clapped, but when Mr. Mel's face they saw by his pale face, they immediately get silent. If you think, Steerforth, that you can use your power as a favorite here to be rude to a gentleman, means you are very famous in the class, you are very favorite of all the boys, but if you are thinking that your favoritism will help you, so it will be not fair with you. Okay, as a favorite here to be rude to a gentleman means if you are getting rude with me, to Mrs. you are not behaving with a student like me, so it will not be the favor of favoritism. A gentleman, I cannot see any gentleman here, said Steerforth, means he is again insulting Mr. Mel. Traddles cried out, shame James Steerforth, that is too bad, means now Traddles' patience has get over. And now what he said that, Steerforth, this is too much, very bad. Okay, you are not going to start insulting Mr. Mel and this is very bad. Mr. Mel told Traddles to be quiet. उन्होंने उसको चुप करा दिया. Too. Then he continued to be rude to someone whose life has been difficult and who has never harmed you is mean and honorable, Mr. Steerforth, means he was telling about his own life, that to be rude, to behave badly with someone who is having very problematic life, very difficult life, and who has never harmed you, जिसने तुम्हें कभी नुकसान नहीं पहुंचाया, उसके साथ rude होना, it's very bad thing. Is mean means it's about only your happiness, कि तुम मुझे dishonor करके you are getting so much happy, but it's very bad. You can sit down or stand up as you like. It's up to you. Now he is not listening to him. जाहिर है वो teacher की बात नहीं सुन रहा, तो what he will say? Obviously he will say that it's up to you. Whatever you want, you can do in the class. Okay. So in this, come to the page number 14 now. Wait a minute, said Steerforth, coming to the front of the room. I tell you, Mr. Mel, when you call me mean and dishonorable, you are a shameless beggar. Now what he is doing, he is again insulting Mr. Mel, his teacher, that you are saying me this all. Okay, you are a shameless beggar. Then suddenly the whole class was quiet and still Mr. Treacle had come. Then suddenly Mr. Treacle had come, and after looking at Mr. Treacle, they become very silent. Mr. Treacle was very angry. He said, Mr. Mel has lost control of the class. Means everybody was shouting and clapping and laughing. So Mr. Treacle came here that, Mr. Mel, you have lost the control. He said that he did not want Mr. Mel to work at the school any longer. Means you cannot control the class, you cannot control the boys, so you are not able to teach in the class, to teach in this school, you may leave, and told him to leave. Then he caned Tommy Traddles for crying because Mr. Mel was leaving. Tommy Traddles started crying that Mr. Mel will be no more over here, and he had to leave. So Tommy Traddles started crying that he hadn't done anything bad, but he had to leave. So Mr. Treacle came with Tommy Traddles that, why are you crying? उन्होंने उससे investigation की उससे पूछा. A few days after this, on my birthday, one of the teachers told me to go to Mr. Treacle. I went happily because I thought Peggotty had sent me a present. Means on his birthday, after a few days, Somebody told David that go to Mr. Creakle's room. He is calling you. So David thought that Miss Peggotty has sent me something present on my birthday. That's why he was very happy to go over there. But when I saw both Mr. and Mrs. Creakle, जब उसने दोनों को देखा वेटिंग फॉर मी इन मिस्टर क्रीकल्स रूम आई न्यू समथिंग वाज रॉन्ग इट मींस उसका जो माइंड था इट वाज टोटली चेंज दैट नो देयर इज नो प्रेजेंट ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ माय मदर एंड पेगोटी इट्स समथिंग रॉन्ग ओवर हियर मिसेस क्रीकल स्पोक टू मी इन अ सैड वॉइस उन्होंने भरी हुई आवाज और दुख भरी आवाज से उससे कहा शी सेड शी हैड समथिंग टू टेल मी अबाउट माय मदर देन आई न्यू माय पुअर मदर वाज डेड उसको उसी वक्त पता चल गया कि हिज मदर हैज डाइड बिकॉज at the time of leaving also his mother was very unhappy and very guilty and her face was very pale wo bahut zyada udaas aur tense ho gayi thi I began to cry wildly I did not know what to do I felt that now I was completely alone in the world now nobody will be here and nobody in this world is here to look after me for me now I am completely alone in this world ab mera is duniya mein koi bhi baki नहीं रहा मिसेस क्रीकल वॉज वेरी काइंड टू मी शी केप्ट मी विद हर ऑल डे उनको एहसास था शी वॉज फीलिंग वेरी सैड वेरी बैड फॉर डेविड दैट हिज मदर हैज डाइड आई क्राइड अंटिल आई वॉज सो टायर्ड दैट आई फेल असलीप वो उस वक्त तक रोता रहा अंटिल ही गॉट वेरी मच टायर्ड एंड ही गेट टू स्लीप जब हम बहुत ज़्यादा थक जाते हैं तो ऑब्वियसली सो जाते हैं तो ही वॉज ऑल द डे मिसेस क्रीकल टुक हिम टुक डेविड टू विद हर सेल्फ एंड He was crying a lot and then after crying he got to sleep. I left Salem House the next afternoon and never returned. Means वो अपने स्कूल से फिर वहाँ से भाग गया और फिर वो दोबारा पलट कर वहाँ पर वापस नहीं आया. So it was the whole lesson number 2. Okay? So if you got any problem, read it very carefully. I will post the this video also and your homework will be posted over there. You have to be very carefully read it okay so that if you found any problem any difficult word you may say you can ask me in the next class even also next class means in the next lecture of literature okay ask the literature question in the literature lecture so you may ask over there in the next lecture of literature if you found any problem okay otherwise I am always present in the class your classroom you may ask any question over there Again, I am telling you that you have to fill up the form which has given to you on your WhatsApp, on your parents, or maybe on your WhatsApp, or it is also uploaded on Google Classroom. So you have to fill that to make the portal online portal by the school, and you have to fill that form very carefully with your particular names and whatever is written over there. You have to give the original information plus rename your IDs. I have. Posted first and second warning on the classroom okay whoever is having is not having the school record name with their IDs okay the IDs are not made with the school record name so you have to rename the IDs and submit the form fill up and submit the form for the portal online portal okay now this is the end of the class I'm going to leave and we will inshallah meet on next Monday and on next Monday you will be having your language class okay we will be having a new topic of language if you have any problem you can ask me in the chat box okay I am here for 2-3 minutes more you can ask me if you have any problem any question regarding this explanation you may ask If you don't have any question, then after 2-3 minutes I leave. And before me, nobody will leave the meeting. Okay, मुझसे पहले कोई नहीं जाएगा. Try to be here. I was continuously watching at the participants point. Only 15 were taking class, and now they are 20. If you people are coming late in the class, I'll not mark your attendance. This is not the right way. Now I am leaving. Thank you so much. No questions are here. And now we will meet on Monday with the language class. Thank you all of you. Thank you so much. Allah Hafiz.